representatives, as we noticed them in the room. Representative Monica, you're up first.
It's not a laughing matter. I'm pretty serious about this bill. I want to demonstrate to you that my bill requires a new safety device to attach to our trailer to our vehicles, and it's House Bill 1479, and it requires trailers with gross weights of 10,000 pounds or less to be equipped with a safety device approved by the Department of Public Safety. It's only required on trailers sold or manufactured in Louisiana on or after January 1st of 2012. It's not retroactive. We have over 600,000 trailers registered in the state of Louisiana. And exempt trailers are sole used for farm purposes. To address the nationally registered trailers, the large rental companies, only trailers registered in Louisiana is required to have this device. And I would demonstrate that the current method of attaching trailers to our vehicles' safety chains are inadequate, and it causes accidents on our highways that result in fatalities. And between my demonstration and the testimony today, I will prove to this committee that this state need to move forward with the newer technology available. Senator, I know you own several trailers, Mr. Chairman, most of the committee members. I own two myself. And this is the current method of attaching the trailers to our vehicle. And see, most of them are welded. You have one link welded to your tongue. And when the trailer with a load, whether it's a small bobcat, small dozer, or a small tractor, if it comes detached from the ball, 9 out of 10 times the chain will fail, then you got a missile on our highways. Okay? The new safety device
that... Where do you get that 9 out of 10 times?
There's no facts, Mr. Chairman. No facts. I will stay away from...
It was a scary fact, is the reason I asked.
Well, it's pretty serious, as you probably are aware that, you know, not all incidents with trailers that get detached off of vehicles are recorded, because sometimes they get detached and the vehicle can maintain the trailer. If the ones that get recorded, the ones that have accidents and fatalities. And I have these stats, and these are facts from the Louisiana State Police. I have the number of crashes caused by trailers that come detached. They don't have the fatalities, but they have the crashes, because some are in municipalities that the state did not record. In 2005, there were 176 crashes, 2006, 173, 2007, 138, 2008, 123, and 2009, 110 crashes. But the chairman, that's from the state police, that are crashes in Louisiana. They couldn't...
Do you have a copy of that for the committee?
I sure do. I'll get a copy for the committee.
Better make copies.
And
copies, please, ma'am.
We have today, Mr. Chairman, I gave some handouts to the committee members yesterday and this morning, and you'll see in the handout the numerous fatalities we have on our highways from trailers getting detached from the vehicle. That should be in your handout. And I have some pictures I would love to show the committee.
Representative Monica, we don't have that handout. Did you give it to us individually yesterday?
I did, sir. And
do you have another copy?
I do have several copies. And I'd love to pass these pictures around, Mr. Sergeant Arm. Those pictures are pictures from actual trailers on our highways that is on our highways. And at this time, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to have two families here to testify that lost family members from an accident. I'd like to have Ms. Priscilla Fusley come to the DS with me and give her testimony.
We also have Robin Richardson wishing to speak. and Stephen Richardson. If, I don't know if y'all have two testimonies to give or just one, but if y'all want to come on up also.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, and to all of y'all here, that this is a living witness.
Would you identify yourself just for the record, please, ma'am?
Priscilla Fuseli.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm here on behalf of my daughter, Michaela Bruno, as a living witness that a runaway trailer can kill. And just an ounce of prevention is why we're here, that it could have probably saved her life and a whole lot of other people's lives. Some of y'all here might have never experienced it, but we are living witnesses that it can happen. And we are here to ask everyone to pass this because a runaway trailer, it is a missile on an open highway. And it does, and it can take lives. And someone else may not be able to tell this story, but I can. It did happen. It can happen again, and it's continuously still happening today. And we're here, and we're asking that this vote be passed because it is a killer on an open highway with these type of trailers, these type of hitches. They're becoming detached from trailers, and vehicles are killing people. And from 1994 to 2003, that's not a long life. But this is the life that my daughter had to have.
Ms. Fuseli, it's probably difficult for you, but could you tell the committee what happened, what malfunctioned, what went wrong
when
that trailer came loose?
On February the 2nd of 2003, we were on our way to church. A trailer that was traveling behind a truck came detached off of the truck, slammed into the left side of the van, killed her instantly, knocked everyone that was to the left side of the van out completely. She was the only one that got killed. I had 6 kids in that van. God could have taken all of us. He gave us a chance to get right, and he took her. From learning this experience, knowing that this can be prevented, this is why we're here. We're asking, we're begging, we're pleading.
You know, did the hitch come uncoupled and the trailer broke on the trailer?
Yes, sir, it sure did. It came detached off of the trailer and slammed into the van and killed her instantly.
Okay, all right, thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Richardson, you want to go first, sir?
Yes, sir. My name is Stephen Richardson, Sr. Mr. Chairman, thank you. Committee members, thank you for this opportunity. Didn't come with a prepared statement. I'm just going to give you some feelings. Please excuse me if I get emotional. May 19th, 2004. Our son turned 20 years old. May 20th of 2004, our son was killed by a runaway vehicle. He was coming home from the state high school baseball championship.
Yes.
Was in the eastbound lane of I-10, and it happened at mile marker 138.6, which for any of you traveling that way is like Marigold Gross Tate exit in that neighborhood. It's in Iberville Parish. The individual that was pulling the vehicle, it was a 80s model Chevy S10 pulling a 90s model Ford Explorer tow bar on the front of the vehicle. If any of y'all have traveled that corridor, you have probably seen a lot of these vehicles going west. It's individuals that go to the East Coast, purchase vehicles, they end up in Mexico is where they're going. What happened was human error, human neglect, in that it was a 1 7/8 inch ball on the towing vehicle. The coupling was a 2 inch. It came off of his vehicle, actually struck his vehicle, and then crossed the interstate. Now take into mind that this is at 10 o'clock at night. My son was 1 of 6 in a vehicle coming back from a baseball game. He was the only one that died. But what happened was the so-called safety chains broke. So what is safe about chains? If you look at any statistical information that comes from construction industry or manufacturing industry, chains are not to be used where public safety is a factor. Why is it allowed? It's a life cut short.